Hi, I'm Dr. Donovan, and in this video, we're going to look at chest infections, including what they are, how to recognize the symptoms, when to seek help, and how to manage and prevent them. Please remember, this video is for educational purposes only. If you're unwell or worried about your symptoms, please do speak with your own healthcare provider. So first of all, what is a chest infection? Well, let's start with the basics. The chest infection is an infection in the lungs or the large airways. It often follows a cold or a flu, and it can range from mild and self-limiting to severe and even life-threatening. Common types of chest infections include bronchitis, which affects the larger airways, and pneumonia, which affects the lung tissue itself. So what are the symptoms? Well, the main symptoms include a chesty cough, often with yellow or green mucus, wheezing or shortness of breath, chest discomfort or pain, a high temperature or tiredness, headache, and aching muscles. Now, these symptoms are usually worst in the first few days, but often improve within 7 to 10 days. However, the cough and the mucus might linger for up to 3 weeks. So let's briefly cover what you can do at home to care for yourself. Well, if your symptoms are mild, there are things you can do to feel better whilst your body fights off the infection itself. And here is what helps. Firstly, make sure you get plenty of rest. Secondly, drink lots of fluids, especially water, to help loosen mucus. Thirdly, use extra pillows to raise your head at night, making breathing easier. You can also take painkillers like paracetamol or ibuprofen to reduce fever and ease aches, and you can try a hot lemon and honey drink to soothe a sore throat. But please don't let children inhale steam from a bowl because it's a burn risk. Don't give aspirin to children under 16, and please don't smoke because this can make symptoms worse and delay recovery. Some people also ask, can a pharmacist help with a chest infection? Well, the answer is yes, they can. Your local pharmacist can recommend cough medications to help loosen the mucus in your lungs. Now, this makes it easier to cough up and clear the infection, but please do note that these are not suitable for children under 6. In terms of when you should go and see your doctor about a chest infection, well, you should see your GP or your family medicine doctor if you feel very unwell or your symptoms are getting worse. If you're coughing up blood, if the cough lasts more than 3 weeks, if you're pregnant, if you're over 65, if you've got a weakened immune system from things like diabetes, chemotherapy, or other causes, or if you've got a long-term condition like asthma, COPD, heart, or kidney disease. That's because in these cases, there may be signs of something more serious like a pneumonia. So what will your GP or family medicine doctor do? Well, if you see your doctor, the treatment is going to depend on what is causing your chest infection. If it's caused by a virus, like a flu or viral bronchitis, antibiotics won't help, and your body will usually recover on its own. On the other hand, if it's caused by a bacteria, like some cases of pneumonia, you may be given antibiotics. Now, it's really important to complete the full course of antibiotics, even if you feel better. Sometimes your doctor might also order a blood test or take a sample of your mucus to work out what is causing the infection. So now let's briefly discuss how to prevent a chest infection. Well, to avoid spreading a chest infection, make sure that you cover your mouth when you cough or you sneeze. Then make sure that you wash your hands regularly using hot water and soap. Make sure you throw away used tissues immediately and stay at home if you've got a high temperature or feel too unwell to carry on with your normal routine. Now, to reduce your risk of getting a chest infection, you should ask your GP about the annual flu vaccine. Also check if you're eligible for the pneumococcal vaccine. Stop smoking if you smoke and try to drink less alcohol because excess alcohol tends to weaken the immune system. Now, these steps are especially important if you're over 65 or if you've got one of the long-term conditions that I mentioned previously. So in summary, chest infections are common, especially in winter. Most are mild and improve with rest and fluids, but some can be more serious, especially in older adults or people with existing health problems. If your symptoms are getting worse, lasting longer than a few weeks, or if you're in a higher risk group, please don't hesitate to get medical advice, and you can always speak to your pharmacist in the first instance. Thanks for watching, and if this video was helpful, please feel free to like, share, and subscribe for more health content. Take care and see you next time.